So you didn't make it to the state meet. These are my, now what? These are my 5 tips to help you get to be a UIL state champion. My name is Saul Cantu, and this is Texas Math Mundo. So what are my 5 tips to help to get you to become a UIL state champion? Well, tip number 1, take a moment to applaud academic excellence. This coming week, the state meet will happen. You should pause, pay attention, and applaud the state champions. If you applaud academic excellence in others, you will seek it within yourself. You know, as a coach, I've taken my teams to many, many tournaments. One of the things I do is I never tell them the results before the award ceremony. Oftentimes, you know, I haven't had the greatest team sometimes, we never won anything, but I forced them to go to the award ceremony because we were gonna applaud academic excellence in others. Like I say, if you applaud academic excellence in others, you will seek it for yourself. Here's another quick story. In 2012, I took a student and I did an interview with him, Dante Vella, and he missed being state champion by 1 question. I told Dante, you're going to go shake the champion's hand and you're going to congratulate him. It's good sportsmanship and you need to recognize and applaud excellence, right? Well, I believe in karma. The very next year, Dante scores the highest math score in the entire state of Texas, regardless of classification. You know, so he applauded academic excellence, and then he went on the grind, worked hard in the off season, worked very hard, and then he became the top scorer in the state. So, tip number 1, take a moment and applaud academic excellence of others, and you will seek it for yourself. Tip number 2, start the journey. There is a saying that the journey of 1,000 miles begins with 1 step. This is true. If you go to the gym and all you can do is lift the bar, well, that's okay. At least you're at the gym working. You will get stronger. I have a couple of personal stories about this. I'm in a tournament once and I'm in the grading room. In a neighboring table, there are a couple of suburb moms, some affluent-looking suburb moms, and they're grading, helping out, which we're very appreciative. And I hear this sympathetic, aw. I'm like, what are they awing about? So I hear the lady comment, oh, look at this kid. This is a math contest. Look at this kid. He only attempted 1, and he missed it. So I turn over, and I look, and sure enough, it's my kid. The great thing about this story is that kid made it to state eventually. Not that year, obviously, but he made it to state. His name's Roberto Moreno. We're Facebook friends. We're all cool. But that's a wonderful story. You know, I don't care how far behind you are. Just get started. Roberto answered 1 question on the math contest, and he missed it. And he missed it, people. It even inspired an awe from a neighboring table of moms. So the point is, doesn't matter how far behind you are, get started. One more story. 5th Ward, Houston, Texas. Very rough neighborhood. There's a kid, Kevin Villalta. He came into 9th grade and he had never heard of a variable. He had never heard of a variable. But you know, he gave his life to practice. He practiced. We're on the grind. Every day, work. One day during practice, he goes, you know, Mr. Cantu, wouldn't it be great if I went to Harvard? And I'm like, well, you want to be an engineer. I think MIT is the top engineering school on the planet. And he's like, MIT? What's MIT? So he didn't even know what MIT was. A couple weeks later, he goes, hey, Mr. Cantu, I was watching cartoons and these chipmunk looking things were wearing MIT sweaters and the chipmunks were wearing geeky and nerdy. And he goes, but now I know what MIT is. Well, today, guess who has a chemical engineering degree from MIT, and he didn't pay a cent full ride. Kevin Vialta. And he came into ninth grade not knowing what a variable was. And Kevin never made it to the state meet. He came out fourth place individually one time. But, you know, Region 3, it's pretty rough with, you know, North Shore and Calculator and Dulles and Clements. It's really a rough journey to try to make the state meet in Region 3 in those days. But that doesn't matter. He got a degree from MIT. And he devoted himself. And he did not even know what a variable was coming into ninth grade. So the point is, don't worry how far behind you are. Start the journey. The off season starts now. Whether you can make it to the state meet next March is about what you do now. Use your off season productively. Get on the grind. Take a moment this week, watch the state meet, pay attention to the results, applaud academic excellence, but then you get on the grind, you get busy, because what you do now, what you do in the summer, what you do now, will determine whether you can make that state meet next March. All right, so that was tip number two. Start the journey. Number three, don't make excuses. Don't accept them and don't make them for yourself. You know, we live in special times. The COVID pandemic has been very tragic, and I'm not cold and heartless here. You know, if tragedy has touched you, of course you have to mourn. Mourn, you know, do what you gotta do, but you gotta live and you gotta continue onward. We have a saying in Spanish, it's kind of harsh, but the sentiment I think I kind of agree with. It says, al muerto el pozo, al vivo el negocio. And roughly translated, it's, you know, the dead go in a hole and the living get back to business. And, you know, that's a harsh sentiment, and, you know, not to be unfeeling and uncaring, but you gotta move on, you gotta work, you gotta keep on with the grind, no matter the circumstances around you. Another popular excuse I've heard people make all the time, we go to a tournament and all these great students there, and says, but they came from a middle school program, they've been doing it since sixth grade. Nobody cares. All that means is that your trajectory is gonna be much greater because you have a much greater trajectory and you're mature now, so keep on going. I don't care if they came from a spectacular middle school program. Nobody else cares. You get on the grind, you make up that ground, you isolate yourself, you work hard. And here goes another excuse some students make. I think my students make it playfully. You know, if I only had a good coach or a teacher, then I could be a state champion. No, don't put it outside yourself. It's on you. This is a digital age. You can get on Khan Academy, you can get on YouTube, you can learn what you need to learn. You put in the work. I don't want to hear about, I don't have a coach, I don't have, you know, colleague. You teach yourself. So, tip number three, don't make any excuses, don't accept any excuses for yourself. Tip number four, let failure fuel your fire. I got two celebrity stories here to illustrate this point. Story number one. In 1994, 1995, in those days, Hakeem Olajuwon and the Rockets made it to the playoffs. Hakeem Olajuwon is my favorite basketball player ever. He's a Hall of Famer. Some of y'all might be young, but he truly was a great Houston Rocket. And so they're in the playoffs, and Charles Barkley fouls him hard. And he takes a spill. And afterwards, in the locker room, the interviewer is asking Hakeem Olajuwon to comment on the incident. And Hakeem Olajuwon said this, and this resonates with me. He says, you don't know a winner when he's winning. You know a winner when he's losing. And so that's so true, because it's how you react to that loss. So are you gonna curl up in a fetal position and just lay that dead? No, of course not. You're gonna pick yourself up, you're gonna get strong, and you're gonna work hard. So you didn't make it to the state meet this year. So what? Gives you a goal for next year. Pick yourself up, work hard, do it. You don't know a winner when they're winning. You know a winner when they're losing. Second story is a Muhammad Ali. You know, Muhammad Ali is considered by many the greatest heavyweight boxer of all time. And so this story, when he died, they televised his funeral, and some person, I don't know, but said this story, and I was like, wow, what a story. So it goes like this. Apparently there was a boxing match between an American and some foreigner, and Muhammad Ali went, and the American won. And in the winner's locker room, there was all sorts of celebration and happiness and, I suppose, champagne. And then Muhammad Ali says this, "I want to go talk to the loser." So of course, Muhammad Ali goes, talks to the loser. And of course, that's a very silent locker room. The loser is all dejected. But of course, that's Muhammad Ali visiting him. In an instant, that loser went from down here all the way to up here. The point of that story is, don't let dejection and loss dampen your spirit. Of course, you're gonna mourn a little bit. Of course, you're gonna hit it. But okay, pick yourself up, get at it. You know what I'm saying? Get at it. Just because you lost, don't mean you just get dejected. It's okay. Get at it. Get at it. And besides, it's a good Muhammad Ali story and speaks of his greatness. All right, so that was tip number four. Let failure fuel your fire. So just to recap, tip number one, take a moment to applaud academic excellence. If you applaud it in others, you will seek it in yourself. Tip number two, start the journey. I don't care how far back you are. I don't care. Start the journey. Tip number three, no excuses. No excuses. Don't accept any excuses for yourself. Keep on grinding forward. Fight the fight. Tip number four, let failure fuel your fire. And the next tip, I think, is the most important tip, the final tip I have to offer. Embrace isolation. Your journey by nature will be a solitary one. Of course, you'll go to practice and you'll be able to share the beautiful math problems and all your work with the coach, hopefully, with your fellow teammates. But the reality is that you need to learn to isolate yourself, bury your head in a book, hour upon hour, night upon night, day upon day, month upon month, year after year. Learn to embrace the isolation and bury your head in a book. It can be a very inglorious existence or path, but you will learn and learn to appreciate the beauty of what you're learning. I think to a certain extent, genius is about temperament. Can you isolate yourself? Can you bury your head in a book? And can you go in and self-teach? So I think that's perhaps the most important tip. So embrace isolation, get comfortable with solitude, bury your head in a book, and then come show us what you got. You know, come show us what you got. Keep the grind. Okay, so those are my tips on how to become a state champion. So if you disagree with me in the comments down below. Say, you're so old school. Come on, man, that's antiquated thinking, man. Come on. Well, then give me better tips. If you got a better tip, put it in the comment below. If you think I'm outdated, explain why down below. So give me a comment down there. If you enjoyed the video, press the like button. Press the like button. And of course, if you'd like this channel to grow, please subscribe. Subscribe, it would really help me out. Hit the subscription button. One message I wanna leave before I go. It's about the journey, okay? It's about the journey. The destination is nice. Of course, you'd like to stand on the mountaintop. Of course, you'd like to stand on stage and have them put a nice gold medal around your neck as number one. But if that doesn't happen, it's okay, because it's about the journey. Your SAT score will increase. You will gain all this beautiful, valuable knowledge. So don't lose sight of the fact that it's about the journey. Of course, you're going to try to win. Of course, you try to get that gold medal. But embrace the journey along the way. Thank you for your time. My name is Saul Cantu, and this is Texas Math Mundo. Farewell.